This is Abid Hussain Malik from Abid Financials, and welcome to third video of section 3 of level 2 exam answer. And this section name is the banking. There would be 10 questions in this exam. You need to pass 80% marks. It means you need to give 8 correct answer for this series. Let's start our questions here. First question is, what is the first step in setting up a corporate credit card account with multiple card holders in the QuickBooks? Four options are here. Option A, linking corporate card to bank account. B, adding primary cardholder details. C, creating a new parent account in the chart of accounts. D, assigning spending limits to each cardholder. The correct answer is option C, creating a new parent account in the chart of account. Question number two. Which of the following statement about reconciling corporate credit card accounts are true? There are four options you need to reconcile: the parent account and sub-accounts. If you reconcile a sub-account, any reconciled transactions will disappear from reconciliation. You can reconcile one sub-account if you wish. Charges and interest show as separate purchase transactions. The correct option is option B. If you reconcile a sub-account, any reconciled transactions will disappear from reconciliation window for the parent account. And correct answer is option D. Charges and interest show as separate purchase transactions. Question number three. When should you post payment transactions from the payment bank account with primary sub account? Select an options you think apply and then select the button in the top right corner to the continue. There are four options here, A, B, C, D. The correct answer is option B, when you are not paying off the full credit card statement's balance. Question number four, our client has informed you that one of their customers has bounced a check. The bank indicated the check was returned for insufficient funds and they are charging $35 return check fee. Your client wants to pass on these charges to their customer. How should they do this? Delete the payment received record, create a credit memo for the amount of the invoice and bounce check fee, create a new invoice using a bounce check item and bounce check fee item, delete the deposit and reiterate excluding the bounce payments. The correct answer is option C, create a new invoice using a bounce check item and bounce check fee item. Question 5, why might QuickBooks not find a match for our transactions in the bank feed? There are four options. The date range for searching is incorrect. The corresponding transaction is posted to the wrong bank account. The corresponding transaction is already reconciled. And the amount of the transactions recorded in QuickBooks is different from amount that cleared the bank. The correct option is option A. The date range from searching is incorrect. And option B. The corresponding transaction is posted to the wrong bank account. And option D. The amount of the transactions recorded in QuickBooks is different from amounts that cleared the bank. We Abid Financial provide the bookkeeping, accounting, payroll and taxation services to USA and the UK based clients, and we have served more than 300 clients worldwide. We also provide the certification services for level QuickBooks level 1, QuickBooks level 2, payroll, desktop, desktop enterprise and intuit bookkeepers. We also deals with the Xero proadvisors and the Xero payrolls. If you need any help or you have any question, you may just message me at my WhatsApp number. You may email at info@abidfinancials.com. For more videos, for training videos or the further training material, you may visit my YouTube channel Abid Financials, where you can find a lot of material about level 1 study material and level 1 exam answers and the e-commerce bookkeeping videos and financial formats like profit and loss course and the budgeting. And you may also find the QuickBooks payroll videos, Xero certification exam answers and the QuickBooks online full training course. And next, move to our next question, that is question number 6. In QuickBooks, how are the individual cardholder account, including the primary structure when setting up corporate credit card account, as independent account, as sub account, as linked bank account, as primary account with no connection to others? Correct answer is option B, sub account under the parent account. If you are setting up a corporate credit card for a client, the cards on primary sub account is only used for prime parent payments, and you are going to post payment transactions from the payment bank account to the primary sub account. Which account should you link to the bank fields? Correct answer is option B, primary sub account. What is the result of posting credit card payments to the primary sub account and creating a journal entry to register the balances? The total liability will show up in primary sub account and non-primary sub account will show a zero balance. The journal entry will be automatically cleared in all sub account. Total liability will be distributed equally. Both primary and non-primary sub account will show the same balance. The correct answer is option A. Total liability will show up in primary account and non-primary sub account will show a zero balance. What should be reconciled to the monthly credit card statement? Select an option and then select submit. Each non-primary sub-account, primary sub-account, parent credit card account do not need to be reconciled. The correct option is parent credit card account. Question number 10. Why might QuickBooks not find a match or suggest an incorrect match between transactions already recorded and transactions in the bank feed? Select all the options you think apply. The correct answer is option A. The amount of transaction posted to QuickBooks is different from amount that cleared the bank, and option B. The transaction is already reconciled, and option E, the transaction was posted to the wrong account, and option F, the date range for searching is not correct. Thank you for watching this video. See you in our next video. Please subscribe my channel. Hit the bell icon button for the new videos. See you in our next video section 3. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.